5-inch gauge Silvercrest Duchess. I'll take you from the back to the front to explain what everything is. The water filling in the tender, you can take the whole panel out or you can open the fillers. Hand pump inside and the back feed from the axle pump on the bypass. Tender's fitted with roller bearing axle boxes which are sealed so they don't need to be oiled. Coming forward, left hand injector water valve, right hand injector water valve, handbrake, and then connecting the engine to the tender, there's three rubber hoses, two water hoses for the injectors which fit just in line to the outside push-on connections. Then the bypass return again is in line with that one, and then the hand pump connection which has got a screwed union nut is on the right hand side. On the foot plate, axle pump bypass valve, screw reverser with indicator board on the top, pressure gauge, left hand injector steam valve, that's an isolating valve for the brake control valve which you might want to turn off for boiler tests, right hand injector steam valve, blower valve, left and right hand water gauge blowdowns. We've already put it in steam, we've got a good fire, and we're ready to go. Now moving forward on the engine, four safety valves, lift out panel so you can remove them for boiler testing. Left hand injector is there. Lubrication, obviously all the points that you see on the outside need to be oiled. Inside there's two big ends, two cylinders with cross edge and guide bars, and then just the valve, it's the inside to outside valve linkage which comes from here, so there's levers in there for that that need oiling. Also there's two eccentrics for the twin axle pump and an eccentric for the lubricator. Moving to the front, twin ram lubricator, use heavy grade steam oil under the cover, and that's about it, I think. I've got spray on the foot plate, manually operated cylinder drain cocks, forward is open, back is shut, and that's all the controls. Thank you.
one.